At this point, there is no sign they are slowing down. The city is desperately trying to brace for impact as hospitals groan under the strain. Today, the governor of New York State, Andrew Cuomo, sent out an SOS signal begging the federal government to send the thousands of ventilators the state will need. New York is becoming a kind of terrible warning that other people around the world are now looking to, the same way we here in the U.S. once looked at Italy. This is precisely why today India announced they are locking down the country's population of 1.3 billion people for the next 3 weeks, a complete nationwide lockdown. And keep this in mind, they're doing this when they only have 536 cases. 536 cases for now. But India is not alone. Leaders of countries all over the world are dealing with the virus. And for the most part, with some notable exceptions, most leaders are not saying things like, well, the flu is really bad too, and a lot of people die from car crashes. And you know, what about the stock market? President Donald Trump began this crisis by downplaying and denying the severity of the virus, saying he liked the numbers where they are, telling us everything was under control, the cases would go down to zero, all while he presided over an abject failure of a response. And then just last week, well, he finally decided to declare a war on the virus, tweeting in all caps occasionally at it. And then after just a few days of said war, it seems like he is now looking to surrender. Today, President Trump participated in a Fox News town hall where he announced he wants to open the country up again by Easter. Why Easter? Because it would be beautiful to see packed churches for the holidays. Easter is 2.5 weeks away. Other countries that have battled this epidemic have had lockdowns for 60 days. The place with the worst outbreak in the world, Wuhan, China, where all this started, they are still under lockdown. Maybe they'll be out in time for Easter. Then when the president was pushed on that Easter goal, he made up a preposterous claim that doctors wanted to keep everyone locked down for 2 years, and no way he was having that, although literally no one is suggesting we stay locked down for 2 years. The president also claimed the flu pandemic in 1918, the deadliest pandemic in recent modern history, that it had a 50% mortality rate, killed one out of every two people. Now, the data we have on the flu pandemic of 1918 is a bit spotty, but there's just no way that's true. In the midst of this global pandemic, at this moment of crisis, the president, as he has been doing daily, as he has done since the first case arrived on our shores, went out today and said things that are flat out wrong, that are lies, and more than that, that are dangerous. And that's why we did not play you any sound of what he said today. Because frankly, the president has become a kind of, well, he's a genuine threat to public health, his rhetoric at this point, the things he says. Here's the reality. Hospitals in the country's biggest city are being pushed to their limit. Local news in Atlanta is reporting that the city's mayor says ICUs across that city are already at capacity, which is a very worrying sign because the numbers of cases in Atlanta would not indicate they had gotten there yet. The CEO of a hospital system in the Detroit area says they are, quote, facing limitations and nearing capacity with our staffing, personal protective equipment, and mechanical ventilators. And the president is out here basically being like, yeah, well, we're all looking to get back to work, Easter, a time of redemption. Now, I should say, lots of the president's staunchest allies and Republicans have disagreed with him on this. They've expressed concern, both Senator Lindsey Graham of South Carolina, Congresswoman Liz Cheney of Wyoming, neither of whom basically ever says anything bad about Trump, have said rushing to open up the country is a bad idea. Right now, Americans across the country are at the very best stuck in their homes or leaving the house because they have to work still in fear of catching the virus or transmitting it to people they love. Others are stuck in overcrowded hospitals, battling a frightening disease with other friends or families by their side. Things are bad because of the virus, which is devilish. They're also bad because the president refused to act early on and because he is still holding back now. And if he continues to swing wildly back and forth and contradict himself and try to sell America on his own response the way you try to get someone to close on a crappy condo, well, then even more Americans are going to suffer.